TV sets, old computer games and stuff like that. Of course, it was not very interactive, but it was more sort of an installation. And I think 5 years ago, we became digital, used all this VJ software, which was available at the market right then. And I don't know, was that since I? I'm sorry. Huh? Yeah, and just for more information about our visuals team, we have a website, which is www.shadowvisuals.com, and as a link with MySpace, and maybe was some need as well as the flash slide. Okay. Yeah, this is a flash website, which unfortunately is not perfect already, but it was a start. And here you have some VJ clips of our team. And maybe King of Boogie.
Yeah.
Yeah, but isn't it sound? Okay, this is just a small example of sort of a mashup. It's made of an old cartoon clip and matched with a very great track from Johnny Dangerous. And yeah, I think it shows the way of DJing, because when I heard the song, I had these pictures in mind, and then it was very easy to get a match between this. Of course, it's not live visuals, it's programmed or before, but yeah, short mashup. And maybe of interest for all the VJs from other countries is the situation, the VJ scene in the part of Bavaria. Of course, we have a very large VJ scene in Munich, which is based, I think, around Harry Klein Club, which is very famous for VJ arts. Beside of Munich, there are at least, I would say, one VJ team per city, but it's not as really accepted, or it's very hard to get party organizers to pay for VJ. I think this is a universal problem for VJing, and but there are some opportunities, and there's also a growing subcultural scene, as in Regensburg, for example, where I'm from. And there's another VJ team called Blink and Remove, and they have a monthly VJ meeting. They invite a lot of other VJs to perform, and it's really a great opportunity, I think, also for other people to come to Regensburg and meet other VJs. And if you're interested, I can give you more information about this. Magst du was über Erlangen erzählen? Yeah, maybe another thing is, beside of VJing, we also try to commercialize our skills, and there's, for example, we produce small clips for clubs with the monthly schedule, for example. Okay, another one. I'm very sorry that we are not so well prepared, but I think it's blanked on the chat leg or something. Okay, this isn't it tough? Hast du mir auch checken? Ist doch mein Tag. Auf dem Fleisch.
Yeah, for example, just small clips which were produced using After Effects, showing the next dates, and well, it's actually it's very boring, you know. I got all the fly material, and I think it's kind of boring just to use the plain information. So I try to creative and make some other things out of it using the Illustrator files and making short animations out of it. And yeah, I think it's a good way to bring some more creative arts into labs, because sometimes it's only just mainstream and it's all not creative, I think. So just a small example. By the way, if you have any questions about VeChain in lower Bavaria or in the deepest outskirts of Bavaria, you're free to ask. Okay, so this is a clip from Martin, and he's going to tell us something about this clip.
Yeah, this is just a short clip I did in Vietnam when I was there for 3 months of work, and it happened really in passing by, because this is documenting my daily way to the work, where I was sitting on a motorcycle with a Vietnamese driver, and yeah, did some impressions of Vietnam. It is if you know maybe Asian countries, it's like they are very very speedy. The traffic is like they are rushing in between and in different directions, and I think this is one of the few socialist things they kept, because if there is from one direction 20 motorcycles and from the other direction 50 motorcycles, the 50 motorcycles are more, and they will do their direction, and if the 20 grew up to 60 motorcycles, they will do their way. And I did it with yeah, very handy slow motion camera, and so I took out the tempo and the speed and did just a few impressions. So, yeah, maybe. Maybe. I have to go over there. And
not like
maybe
a little bit higher. Is that something?
Yeah, and the idea behind this is I think it's very boring to do visuals just in this typical 4:3 format. Just put a screen somewhere and a video projector. And the idea of shadow visuals is always to occupy a whole location, a whole room, and to do something which is more evolving. Which is we started with this half transparent projection screens where you could put different layers afterwards, and then I came over this prism thing, and this was the first idea, which is just on a motor for disco balls, for mirror balls, and the basic idea was to have two VJs or maybe two VJ teams, which are mixing digitally with maybe with an
Eddie Roll V4 or a Panasonic, and to put two projectors there and to mix the digital material analog way on the wall again in between with the prism thing. And this has been a little bit evolved, yeah. There's one.
So it's switching? Don't see.
Need some sound. Because the next idea was not just to do it constantly, which is more for a chill out room, and we are just waiting a little bit. One track, iTunes. And they are now controlled by sound. It's maybe even more impressive if I do a little more pedal way. Fast because I had a little problems with the setups because this is just a little soldering board I did as a testing module, and it's not quite finished for real use in real locations, but the next step is to fix it up with two potentiometers, and then you can control the level, how fast this is reacting, and how you can adjust the level of the sound is coming in, and put it in a little black box, and then you just wire it up. So the next step was, and this is not quite working before I burnt my fingers because it's really getting hot, and the next step was to control it by MIDI. There's also the thing that you have maybe eight buttons on your MIDI mixer, and you can wire it up with a MIDI signal, and then you adjust this with eight different levels of positioning, and then you can use the MIDI controller you normally use for changing your clips and your VJ software, and in the same way you change your clip, the position of the prism is changing. Yeah. But unfortunately it's not working, maybe I get it later once. So, another thing to say.
So I'm just to mention another VJ software which was not concepted to be a VJ software. I think it was in... It's called VVVV, V4 short. I don't know if anybody knows it already. It's sort of patching software, and I think it was created by Miese from Germany, which are responsible for all this glut technique in Frankfurt, and this Cocoon Glut from Sven Feth, and they developed a great piece of software, which is, I don't know, I can show you how a typical, I don't know if it's working now, it's not working. Just, and this is a typical patch here. Can you see? Yeah, and this is, the technique behind it. It's, you have different nodes, you can generate geometric shapes, and you have audio input from the mic, and you can just create patterns and things that react to the sound. And I think it's a good complement to the typical VJ software, but of course it's not really appropriate for VJing alone, because you always need a backup when you want to change a patch, because it always takes about some seconds but the next clip is loaded. But I think it's worth it twice.
Sibi, may I ask something?
Yeah, for sure, Pucho, please.
How do you make it? I couldn't understand.
Huh?
How do you make this?
With
the patch you set in a program?
It's a little bit hard to recognize here, but really it's, you see this gray rectangles,
mm-hmm.
and these are nodes, which means they get a certain...
It's
similar like Max MSP is I never used by
kind of graphical programming where just you don't use text and do your whole programming in a whole text, because you have certain objects and certain objects all have different meanings, and then you can wire it up and
each node gets an input like data, for example, like numbers, and generates an output, and with this output you can generate geometric things like...
function, like change the shape?
It's similar like this, you have mathematical nodes,
mm-hmm.
and you have like generating nodes like cubes or circular shapes.
Uh-huh.
And it's also very good because it has a lot of input nodes which cover things like graphic tablets or MIDI controller as well, I think, audio input, so it's also perfect for JoyPad, FireWire, you can do it. I didn't program the software, I just use it, but... No, it's well, because I developed this patch, I used all these nodes to create something, and I also have some possibilities to, I don't know, I have a lot of input parameters like changing the color and making sort of a grid which can't be seen on because it's too important. I can change the text, so there's a lot of interactivity still allowed then. So it's not only like a WinAmp visualization. But I think it's a good complement to normal DJ software, because you can easily create some text, and you have full OpenGL functionality, so a lot of things to do. Yeah. Any more questions? Or?
Yeah, I have one more question. Is it possible to get all the URLs written on the page after the workshop?
Well, I would suggest all the people who are interested. I don't care. Just a minute. I think in general we use all this normal software, like, okay.
Yeah, the usual problem is that as a VJ you just arrive in time and you don't get paid for the extra time you spend in doing a really good setup. And the next step is you are most of the time you are provided maybe two meters of space, and where should you put all your stuff you want to bring with you? So usually we just do a normal VJ setup, and it's not like we would like to do, yeah. So the normal club in Germany isn't really prepared for really good visuals. It's always the same setup. As a DJ came and he has his two Technics and his Pioneer mixer, a VJ has to bring all his on his own, and and then you have to fix it up, and something is maybe not working, and yeah. So usually it's better to go the easy way, yeah. So,
and, as I told before, this is not, in general, we use the normal software as well, like myself on a Windows PC, Resolume, the other two use Modulvite or Modulate, And what else? Clip generation is, I use things like Illustrator, Photoshop, After Effects. And yeah, I think just, no, not Premiere, Adobe Premiere. And yeah, that's not, what? Yeah, another thing is maybe interesting because I told you about Shadow was founded 8 years ago, and last year we teamed up with some other guys in Munich, like for example Sascha Günne. Sascha is not here right now, but he will DJ this night, and to create something like an audiovisual collective with many different people, and also with the chance to maybe create some audiovisual acts. But this is just began last year, so we will see. And this audio collective is called Kopfhüßler, which is and there's also a link on our MySpace site to it. And Munich at a drum and bass party, and you see the similar V4 patch now in action, and yeah, you can find a lot of VJ clips which were recorded live at these events in Munich, or I don't know, Regensburg for example, and Karlsruhe, and so on. And well, unfortunately it's not updated very great, but you could find more information also about Sascha Günne, for example. And this is, for example, a clip of another VJ in this audio collective who is called, he knows him better, so.
Some words. This, and also on the other screen is running, it's a software he developed as on Director. He did it on his own, and it's it was his final work for university, and he did our own VJ software, which is called Mutant, as he is, he calls himself as VJ, yeah. And yeah, something else. Kopfhüßler is using maybe more. They are going to VDMX. Maybe you know it. It's from, what is the software firm? It's Bitmage Grid. Yeah, you find it. It's also a Mac-only software, and it's very, I think, quite similar to Module 8, and it's also module-based, and you can do your own pattern chains, and I think what is a great opportunity, effort, what is it, Vorteil? Advantage to Module 8, it has the so-called blend modes, which you know from some compositing software and editing softwares, yeah, where you can do multiply, screen mode, additive, subtractive, and things like this, and therefore you can do some more combination of different materials, which is not as good in Module 8 to do. Yeah. Something else? I don't know. Yeah, questions?
Do you use Director before you talk to program Director?
Director? It's now it's a new version available, but this is done with the very old version, and I'm not really familiar with Director. I can just play some clips, but if you Director is very similar to Flash, and but more powerful than Flash. Flash gets more powerful, but Director was always more stronger than Flash. And as in Flash, you can do your shockwave movie. If you do rendering out, you got your .svf. And you can also do in Flash a so-called standalone .exe file, .exe, or on Mac, they are also standalone. So you do on Flash a rendering out, not as SVF, so also you do it as a whole software, as a program, yeah? And same way you can do it in Director. So you don't have to open up Director to use his software. It's just like the interface where you can put your JPEGs in. He's working not so much with video, it's more like just still images which are distorted and dissolving from the software own effect patterns. Yeah.
But I think in general you can say when it's about club visuals, you have to react to the location, to the people. It makes no sense to make very sophisticated hardware setups when it's not really asked for, you know. So sometimes we just make a very quick and easy setup in clubs and just make usual clip, yeah, not mixing but VJing, so without using other software. So I think experimenting is only for really art exhibitions, or if you really have some subculture and not really in this usual mainstream clubs, because it's really not honored as well. So why to bother with it? Yeah. So yeah, and I don't know if you any questions, because I think we showed you a lot of things which are not directly sometimes found in our live visuals, but anyway, we have, I think it's 1:30 today, we will make visuals for Sascha Günay of the Kopfhüdler Collective, and if there aren't any questions, I would like to thank for the invitation to Turkey, and really big respect for all this perfect organization here, so we are very glad to be invited here, so thanks a lot. And special questions, yeah, we afterwards or something, I don't know, and maybe here's a short clip done by me in 8-bit aesthetics, and it's a short respect and greetings, like it was done for all this demo stuff back in the 80s. Some VJs we cooperated so far, like Blink and Move from Regensburg, Schallbild von Erlangen, Department of Volksvergnügen, which is also something like an open VJ platform in Munich. So they would be glad also to have some international VJs maybe, so contact them if you want to come to Munich, and yeah, that's all. So thanks for your attention. Yeah.
Do you have any questions?
We got a bunch of questions, but
maybe it's better you come just in front of me.
Mostly, as far as I understand, mostly you use Macintosh, isn't it?
I'm still using Windows PC, but recently I have big problems with credit cards, so I think of switching to Mac as well, like the other two guys. But for me, it was never a problem to use Windows PC, because there's similar great software for it. I think Resolume is really a great program, and I don't know, I think it's comparable. I think it's not all about Mac all the time. And anyway, it doesn't depend on the hardware, more about being creative, so it's not platform dependent.
So, I just asked for this, if you use PC, we really would like to dig in to this computer to see what's inside. I mean, in the festival page, I saw two or three software. I tried to download. I just could download one, Resolute. And the rest I couldn't get. So I would be really happy to get them, and also the setting up. I mean, I need some practical information to do something immediately.
Yeah, we will. No, but I would suggest to.
I'm happy. I got a CD now.
Okay, you got a CD, so.
But,
Yeah, but in general, I think it's a lot of try and error. It's really there's no as before as a loom. You can have big problems and okay, support is okay, but yeah, and not always use the latest version because I'm still using there's loom 2.2 because 2.4 is not stable on my PC. But I think this year they are going to release ResLoom 3 for Mac as well, so I'm curious about it, yeah. So, and in general, this is, for my part, the only software I use really for live visuals, ResLoom and sometimes with V4 patches. And I never tried like Archaos, I think it's for Windows as well, or Motion Dive, or I don't know exactly. I think it depends on yourself which software fits best for you. But I think ResLoom is a good point to start with.
As the guy yesterday said, ResLoom is more about video stuff. And it's a Windows only software. And Module 8 is more for graphical stuff. And it's, unfortunately, it's Mac only.
Yeah, another thing I just remembered, ResLoom is also great if you come from this ActionScript Flash program inside, because ResLoom can exchange parameters, so you prepare a Flash file and you can interactively react with these parameters from ResLoom. So for example, making some text animations or controlling parameters. So.
Maybe the same with Module 8, you can do a Quartz Composer, which is in the developer kit from Apple. And that's also like the software CV demonstrated before, it's also graphical based programming language where you have your different patterns and you can switch it up with, wire it up with different cables. And they are rendered out as a QuickTime movie, which is typical Mac, or as a Qt set, and they can easily import it in your VJ software.
Was wollt ihr aussagen?
Yeah. And this is Sascha Günay, which is a DJ, DJ performing. He was once in former time he was doing visuals as well, but he said he wants to concentrate on music now. And
good idea. I gotta see.
No, and sometimes it's really hard because when you go to this clubs and it's all I like electronic music, but these days it's really not very creative and. So I think you have to blame the DJs for the music as well. It's not, and you have to be thankful for DJs to open another platform for creative art in clubs, because
it's like if you have good sound, you're doing good visuals. So as DJ, you also you like to, if you like the music, you can do better visuals.
Yeah. So it's I think it's cooperation sometime. It will react to each other, so yeah.
Schwätze, Schabe.
Okay.
Servus.